If you have one of these, or this, or this, or even this, you need to start thinking about cybersecurity. Sure, IoT devices can make your home, household, or even health much easier to manage. But have you stopped to consider that it can harm you too? Here are three ways IoT security can and has gone wrong. If you had a kid, or even a pet, a baby monitor is a great way to keep an eye on them. A camera to give you a view of what's happening, a mic to hear what they're up to, and maybe even a speaker to keep them in check. Well, what if the voice from your baby monitor isn't the one you recognize? This is what happened to a family in Mississippi when an intruder hacked their home camera and started speaking to an 8-year-old, asking her to destroy her stuff.
You can mess up your room. Can break your TV, can do whatever you want.
The terrified daughter started yelling for help.
Mommy!
And they were far from the only ones whose cameras got hacked. Sounds like a nightmare, right? Well, the Ring home security camera is far from the only IoT device that have terrifying vulnerabilities. Back in 2017, the FDA recalled 500,000 pacemakers due to cybersecurity fears. The administration found that would-be hackers could drain the pacemaker's battery and even deliver shocks that could kill the patient. Similar life-threatening vulnerabilities were found in insulin pumps. If a hacker took control of the device, they could mess with a medication dose or show false medical readings. And it doesn't end there. Appliances, smart TVs, and even your car can be vulnerable. What if all these devices were taken over at the same time? That's what happened in 2016 when a distributed denial-of-service attack left much of the internet in the US and Europe slowing to a crawl. The culprit? Mirai, a giant network infected IoT devices that turned into remotely controlled bots. Creating a botnet wasn't difficult. Many of the IoTs taken over still had their default usernames and passwords. Hundreds of websites, including Reddit, GitHub, Airbnb, were inaccessible for hours, and the internet of the entire countries slowed down. These stories illustrate the big picture problem that affects most smart devices. They aren't actually smart. Most internet-connected devices have pretty low processing power. This means that the smart light bulb or fridge probably won't come equipped with encryption. Different devices also use different protocols to communicate, like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and NFC. So making one unified security standard is a challenge. Another issue is the factory settings. Even if the IoT device comes with a password, a lot of the time it's something like admin or password. And it's not always possible for the user to change. And if you don't have a password, well, then you might find your security camera on Shodan, a search engine for unsecured devices. Worst of all, a lot of people don't seem to care. A while ago, NordVPN did some research on IoT security. Nearly 9 out of 10 people have at least one IoT device in their homes, with the most popular being routers and smart TVs. But just over 35% change the default password on their router or other smart devices. And the average percent of people who have a VPN on the router? Just 19.6%. So what can you do to protect your home? 1. Do your research. Make sure the device has proper security features and settings in place. 2. Change the default passwords. 3. Set up a VPN on your router. This way, you can protect devices that don't support a VPN. 4. Create a separate network on your IoT devices. Potential hacker wouldn't be able to gain access to all of your devices at once. 5. Keep your firmware up to date. Manufacturers release security patches, so keep your IoT updated. Don't forget, if it has an internet connection, it can be hacked. Are you going to do anything about it?